Dr. Bruce Banner and his rage-driven alter ego, created by Stan the Man Lee and Jack the King Kirby, debuted in Marvel Comics' The Incredible Hulk in 1962. Though that was a bit before my time, the green-skinned Goliath shot to the top of my list of many favorite Marvel superheroes in the late 70s, early 80s. I was first introduced to the Hulk in the Marvel Comics of the era and managed to catch a few reruns of the 60s cartoon series. But my young impressionable mind was about to be blown when CBS aired the live-action television series The Incredible Hulk in 1978. To say the least, the series made me an even bigger fan. For more on my thoughts about The Incredible Hulk TV series, click on the link following the review. A few years later, a new cartoon series aired in 1982 that fueled my enthusiasm for the Hulk even more. Long story short, going back as far as my preteen years, I've always wanted The Incredible Hulk to make the leap to the big screen. The first silver screen adaptation debuted in 2003, simply titled Hulk. Though I was initially excited, unfortunately, aside from a few well-done action set pieces and interesting psychological character studies of its main cast, director Ang Lee and company's Hulk left something to be desired. Most fortunately, a mere 5 years later, following the release of the immensely popular Iron Man, as well as the launch of Marvel Studios, a reboot of Hulk hit theaters in 2008. Intended to be in the same universe and interconnected with Iron Man as well as subsequent Marvel Studios films, this time its title ripped straight from its comic book counterpart. The Incredible Hulk's film tone is much more in line with not only the source material, but its 1978 television adaptation as well. However, Incredible Hulk is one of the few Marvel films that seems to be critically panned or forgotten about whenever the Marvel Cinematic Universe is discussed. And I for one think it deserves better. In my opinion, it's just as integral to the early stages of the MCU as Iron Man or Avengers. And personally, I'm just as entertained by Hulk as I am the aforementioned Marvel films. Mad About Superheroes presents Comic Book Movie Flashback, The Incredible Hulk. On the run from the U.S. Army and General Ross, Bruce Banner hides out in Brazil. He has taught himself meditation techniques in an attempt to control his transformations and hasn't hulked out in months. Ross discovers Banner's whereabouts and sends a strike team led by Emil Blonsky to bring Banner back. The mission goes awry, with Banner eventually changing into the green-skinned alter ego. Hulk decimates Blonsky's team and injures Blonsky himself before escaping. Banner makes his way back to the U.S., where he finds his former girlfriend, Betty Ross, working at Culver University. Meanwhile, General Ross offers Blonsky another chance to subdue Hulk. The experiment that turned Banner into Hulk was a failed attempt to duplicate the super soldier serum that created Captain America. Blonsky is given an altered version of the serum, increasing his strength. Banner and Betty travel to New York, where they meet with a scientist named Samuel Stearns, who may have a cure for Banner's condition. Banner takes the cure, which reverses his transformations. He is then captured by General Ross's team. Blonsky demands Stern give him an infusion of the serum he administered to Banner, hoping to increase his strength. It works, but also transforms Blonsky into a grotesque monster. This abomination rampages through New York City, hoping to draw out Hulk. General Ross agrees to let Banner fight Blonsky, and Banner leaps from a helicopter to jumpstart his transformation into the Hulk. Hulk defeats the abomination but is forced to flee from the army once more. As mentioned, I'm a big fan of the classic Incredible Hulk TV series, and the 2008 film really delivers on some nice fan service in the form of Easter eggs, referencing the late 70s small screen interpretation. Culver University is a reference to the Culver Institute, where Dr. David Banner is exposed to gamma radiation. The opening titles of the film closely follow the opening titles of the TV series. A package for Banner is addressed to David B. This refers to the fact that Banner would have a different surname beginning with B in each episode of the TV series. The two students who are interviewed by journalists after the fight at Culver University are called Jack McGee and Jim Wilson. Jack McGee was the name of the reporter who pursued David Banner in the classic 70s TV series. In the comic books, Jim Wilson was also the nephew of the Falcon. Craig Armstrong, who composed the score for the film, includes the moving piano and title theme from the TV show named The Lonely Man in the score. The TV series lead actors both make fleeting appearances. The late Bill Bixby appears on a TV screen in a scene from the movie The Courtship of Eddie's Father. The first live-action Hulk, Lou Ferrigno, plays a security guard and also voices the Incredible Hulk. With a well-rounded cast of Hollywood elite, Incredible Hulk features Fight Club star Edward Norton as Dr. Bruce Banner, Armageddon's Liv Tyler as Betty Ross, Reservoir Dogs star Tim Roth as Emil Blonsky, and film veteran William Hurt as General Thaddeus Thunderbolt Ross. A personal highlight of the film is Hurt's performance as the overbearing military vet and domineering father to Betty. Apparently, the powers that be at Marvel Studios felt the same way, giving Hurt the chance to reprise his role of General Ross in Captain America: Civil War. William Hurt played a small but memorable part in another comic book movie released a few years prior, History of Violence, in 2005. Similar to the way Terrence Howard was recast with Don Cheadle as James Rowdy Rhodes in the Iron Man series, Edward Norton is replaced by Mark Ruffalo to take over the role of Dr. Banner and his alter ego in the subsequent MCU films. Ruffalo was actually the Incredible Hulk director, Louis Leterme's first choice for the role, but the film producers wanted Norton instead. I wasn't entirely pleased with Eric Bana's performance as Dr. Banner in Ang Lee's Hulk, but was totally on board with Norton's portrayal of the character in the Marvel Studios reboot, so I was admittedly skeptical for another actor taking over the role. However, in hindsight, I can honestly say any reservations I had to Ruffalo taking over the role in Avengers have been completely laid to rest. Being a huge Hulk fan, I've thoroughly enjoyed the evolution of the character throughout the respective Marvel films. Aside from a few nitpicks, such as some poorly aged CG and some setups for future films that don't pay off, like Stern's becoming the leader, I really enjoy Incredible Hulk. It delivers some well-played dramatic tension, some nicely executed melodrama, and the action set pieces are very well staged and fun to watch, especially the Hulk's first encounter with Blonsky before he becomes the Abomination. If you haven't seen The Incredible Hulk, I definitely recommend giving it a chance, despite what you may have heard. And if you have seen it, I hope I've at least inspired you to rewatch it.
Your target is a fugitive from the U.S. government who stole military secrets.
This is the location. Snatch and grab only, live capture.
Take him.
As I'm concerned, that man's whole body is property of the U.S. Army.
You have to get as far away from me as you can. Go!
There are aspects of my personality that I can't control.
Target is in the overpass.
And when I lose control, it's very dangerous to be around me.
He's going in.
Pull back now.
Hulk! Smash!
Thanks for letting your geek flag fly with Mad About Superheroes. Don't forget to like, subscribe, and comment.